Welcome to all. Today I am going to explain electromagnetic wave theory. So electromagnetic waves are used in many applications such as radio communication, TV communication, radar communication, etc. So today we will study what are the uniform plane waves, general wave equation, propagation of VM waves, duration of wave constant, wave polarization, power flow and pointing vector, and some numericals are solved. So first we study what are the uniform plane wave. Plane means the E bar and H bar vectors, that is electric field and magnetic field vectors, both lies in a plane and all such planes are parallel. The meaning of uniform is the amplitude and phase of vectors. Electric field and magnetic fields are constant over a phase planes. In figure, we have chosen the E bar in Y direction and H bar in Z direction. The E bar and H bar are in YZ plane and are plane waves. So there are some EM wave constants come across in the EM wave theory. So first one is propagation constant. Symbol is gamma. Gamma of a EM wave is measure of the undergone with amplitude and phase of the wave as it propagates in a given direction. So next, gamma is a complex quantity, the sum of alpha and beta. Next one is alpha is attenuation constant. Alpha of EM wave propagating through a medium per unit distance from the source. It is real part of propagation constant and is measured in Nappers per meter. So next, phase constant. Beta of a EM wave represents the change in phase per unit length along the path traveled by the wave. It is imaginary part of the gamma. So next, we will derive the general uniform plane wave equation in conducting medium. So we know that there are four Maxwell equations. One is curl of E bar is equal to minus dou by dou t B bar. Second one is curl of H bar is equal to J bar plus dou by dou t D bar. Third one is divergence of D bar is equal to rho V. And fourth one is del dot V bar is equal to 0. So by using this equation, we can derive the expression general wave equation. So taking curl on both sides of the equation, Maxwell equation number 1, we get curl of E bar is equal to delta into bracket minus rho by dou t B bar, where B bar is equal to mu H bar, if it becomes minus mu into rho by dou t curl of H bar. But the triple product formula of the curl vector, we get the gradient of del dot E bar minus E bar del dot D is equal to mu dou by dou T, where curl of H bar is equal to from equation number 2 sigma E bar plus epsilon dou by dou T E bar from 2. But this gradient of del dot E bar is equal to 0, therefore minus del square E bar is equal to minus mu sigma dou by dou t E bar minus mu epsilon dou square by dou square E bar. So minus sign cancel out, we will get the equation del square E bar is equal to mu sigma dou by dou t E bar plus mu epsilon dou square by dou square E bar in terms of E bar. So multiplying both sides of equation of A by E epsilon, we get del square epsilon E bar is equal to mu sigma dou by dou t epsilon E bar plus mu epsilon dou square by dou t square epsilon E bar. So we'll get epsilon E bar is equal to D, therefore we'll get delta square D square is equal to mu sigma dou by dou t D bar plus mu epsilon dou square by dou t square D bar. This is in terms of D bar. So taking curl on both sides of the equation number 2, we'll get curl del into del curl of color x bar is equal to del into sigma e bar plus del into del curl of epsilon dou by dou t bar. So by the, again the formula you will get, and substituting del of del dot s bar is equal to 0, you will get del square s bar is equal to mu sigma dou by dou t s bar plus mu epsilon dou square by dou t square s bar in terms of s bar. Multiply equation number c by mu on both sides, you will get del square b bar is equal to mu sigma dou by dou t b bar plus mu epsilon dou square by dou t square b bar. It is in terms of, that is d bar. In general, in matrix form, it can be written as del square e bar d bar s bar d b bar is equal to mu sigma dou by dou t, and in the first column s bar e bar d bar s bar d bar plus mu epsilon dou square by dou t square. So e bar d bar s bar b bar. So for dielectric medium, general equations are obtained by putting sigma is equal to 0. Then you will get del square e bar is equal to mu epsilon dou square by dou t square e bar. In terms of e field, del square d bar is equal to mu epsilon dou square by dou t square d bar. In terms of d field, and del square s bar is equal to mu epsilon dou square by dou t square s bar in h field, and del square b bar is equal to mu epsilon dou square by dou t square b square b in terms of b field. Derivation of wave propagation equation in conducting medium. We know that general wave equation in terms of E field is given by del square E bar is equal to mu sigma dou by dou t E bar plus mu epsilon dou square by dou t square E bar. Which number one. Let the wave travels along x direction. Then when Ex is equal to 0, d by dy is equal to 0, d by dz is equal to 0, and assume Ey is present and Ez is equal to 0. Therefore, dou square by dou x square Ex, x bar plus dou square by dou x square Ey, Ey bar plus dou square by dou z square Ez, Ez bar is equal to mu sigma dou by dou t bar plus mu epsilon dou square by dou t square E bar. So, then we will get simplification. Substituting the conditions, you will get dou square by dou s square Ey is equal to mu sigma dou by dou t Ey plus mu epsilon dou square by dou t square Ey. Let Ey is equal to E naught E raised to j omega t. Therefore, if you differentiate Ey, you will get dou by dou t Ey is equal to j omega Ey, and dou square by dou t square is equal to j omega square Ey. Therefore, dou square by dou square Ey is equal to mu sigma j omega Ey plus mu epsilon j omega square Ey. If take Ey outside, you will get j omega mu sigma plus j omega whole square mu epsilon. Let gamma square is equal to j omega mu sigma plus j omega square mu epsilon. Therefore, gamma is equal to under root of j omega mu into bracket sigma plus j omega epsilon. Therefore, equation number 3 is a linear second order differential equation with m square is equal to gamma square and m is equal to plus or minus gamma constant coefficients. Solution of equation number 3 is Eyx is equal to em plus e raised to minus gamma x plus em minus e raised to plus gamma x. Equation number 4. Let gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta, and multiply equation number 4 of RHS by e raised to j omega t. Therefore, Ey xt is equal to real term of em plus e raised to minus alpha x e raised to minus j beta x plus em minus e raised to plus alpha x e raised to plus j beta x whole bracket e raised to j omega t. Therefore, Ey is equal to em plus e raised to minus alpha x cos omega t minus beta x plus em minus e raised to alpha x cos omega t plus beta x. This first term is the incident wave and the second term is the reflected wave. Thus, e raised to plus j theta is real plus imaginary term. Similarly, for x field, if hx is equal to 0, z is present as e y is present and h y is equal to 0. Therefore, h z is equal to h m plus e raised to minus alpha x cos of omega t minus beta x plus h m bar e raised to alpha x cos of omega t plus beta x. So here the first term is incident wave, this is also reflected wave. For dielectric medium, alpha is equal to 0. Therefore, Ey and Hz field becomes Ey is equal to Em plus cos omega t minus beta x plus Em bar m minus cos of omega t minus beta x. And Hz is equal to Hm plus cos omega t minus beta x plus Hm minus cos omega t plus beta x. Next, we'll solve one problem on this. An uniform plane wave, 1 MHz propagating in a large block of copper for which conductivity is equal to 5.8 into 10 raised to 7 Siemens per meter and permittivity is equal to 1 and permittivity is equal to 1. Find the following: attenuation and phase constant, intrinsic impedance of copper, velocity of propagation and lambda. Given frequency f is equal to 10 raised to 6 Hz, therefore omega is equal to 2 pi of radians per second. Therefore sigma is given 5.8 to 10 raised to 7 Siemens per meter. Relative permittivity is 1. Relative permittivity is 1. Therefore, but mu naught is equal to 4.8 to 10 raised to minus 7 ampere per meter. And E naught is equal to 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12 farad per meter. Gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta under root of j omega mu sigma plus j omega epsilon. Substitute the values of sigma, omega and mu and epsilon and simplify. You will get gamma is equal to under root of 4.58 into 10 raised to 8, angle is 90 degree. Therefore gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta and is equal to 2.14 into 10 raised to 4, angle 45 degree. Convert into rectangular coordinate, you will get 1.51 into 10 raised to 4 plus j into 1.51 10 raised to 4 per meter. Therefore, alpha, attenuation constant alpha is equal to 1.51 into 10 raised to 4 Napier per meter and beta is equal to 1.51 into 10 raised to 4 radian per meter. Similarly, efficiency is given by under root of j omega mu divided by sigma plus j omega epsilon and substitute the value of omega mu sigma and omega, we get eta is equal to under root of 1.36 into 10 raised to minus 7 angle 90 degree. Then it becomes 3.69 to 10 raised to minus 4 angle 45 degree. Hence magnitude of its intrinsic impedance is 3.69 to 10 raised to minus 4 ohm and angle is 45 degree. Next, velocity of propagation is given by omega by beta. But omega is equal to 2 pi f and beta is given 1.5 into 10 raised to 4. The substitution simply will get 416 meter per second. Similarly, wavelength is given by 2 pi by beta, 2 pi and beta is given 1.5 into 10 raised to 4. If you simplify, you will get 4.16 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter. Next expression for gamma, alpha, beta, lambda, Vp and Vg. We know that gamma square is equal to j omega mu instead of bracket sigma plus j omega epsilon. Therefore, gamma is given by under root of j omega mu into bracket sigma plus j omega epsilon for conductor. And gamma is equal to under root of j omega mu, j omega epsilon is equal to j omega mu under root of mu epsilon for dielectric. Alpha plus j beta is equal to 0 plus j omega under root of mu epsilon. Therefore, alpha is equal to 0 and beta is equal to omega under root of mu epsilon for dielectric. Therefore, for conductor, gamma square is given by omega plus j beta whole square j omega mu sigma plus j omega epsilon. If you square and equate, here we will get gamma square minus beta square is equal to minus omega square mu epsilon and 2 alpha beta is equal to omega mu sigma. Substitute the value of alpha omega mu sigma divided by 2 pt from B in A. We will get alpha is equal to under root of minus omega square mu epsilon by 2 plus under root of omega raised to 4 mu square epsilon square plus omega square mu square sigma square divided by 2. For dielectric, sigma is equal to 0. Therefore, we will get alpha is equal to 0 and beta is equal to omega under root of mu epsilon wavelength. It is the distance a wave must travel to change the phase by 2 radian. So, lambda is given by 2 pi by beta, and it is also given by lambda is equal to c by m. Phase velocity is the velocity of phase wave with which the phase of the wave propagates. So, here let m is equal to omega t minus beta x. Differentiate equation number 1 with respect to t. We get dm by dt is equal to d by dt. The differentiation of omega t minus beta x. So, we get w is equal to dx by dt beta. Therefore, dx by dt is equal to omega by beta. Dx by dt is the velocity given by omega by beta. Therefore, Vp is equal to 1 divided by under root of epsilon. For dielectric, Vp is equal to 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second. Group velocity, it is the velocity with which the signal or group of frequencies travels to the system. So, Vg is given by dw by d beta. So, next we will solve one problem. An inform plane wave propagating in a perfect dielectric medium which has E bar is equal to 500 into cos of this one. S bar is equal to 1.1 into cos of 1070 minus beta z ay. If the wave is traveling with velocity of U is equal to 0.5c meter per second, find epsilon r, mu r, beta, lambda and eta. So, intrinsic impedance given by Ex by Hy, 500 by 1.1, is also given by mu by epsilon, and mu r, mu naught, epsilon r, f naught. Substitute, we get 377 under root of mu r by epsilon r. And also, Vp is equal to 1 by under root of mu epsilon. We substitute, we get c divided by mu r epsilon r. Given if Vp is equal to 0.5c, we substitute and simplify, we'll get epsilon r is equal to 1.659 and mu r is equal to 2.4 and beta is equal to omega under root of mu epsilon, and substitute the value of mu naught epsilon naught mu r epsilon r, we'll get and beta is equal to 0.067 radian per meter and lambda is equal to 2 pi by beta. 2 pi by 0.067, we get 93.73 meter. And eta is equal to 377 under root of mu r by epsilon r is equal to 453.44. So next is linear polarization. Consider uniform plane wave is traveling in z direction. So if only x component is present and E y is equal to 0, then the wave is polarized in the x direction. If only Ey is present, Ex is 0, then the wave is polarized in the y direction. If Ex and Ey both are present and they are in phase, then the direction of resultant E bar depends on the relative magnitude of Ex and Ey, and theta is equal to tan inverse Ey by Ex. Let uniform plane wave traveling in lossless medium in plus x direction is E bar xt is equal to em cos omega t minus beta x along ey, and s bar x of t is equal to em by eta cos of omega t minus beta x along z direction. So variation of e bar and z bar at x is equal to 0. So e bar 0 t is equal to em cos omega t, s bar 0 t is equal to em by eta cos omega t. So, now rotate vector field ext and h3 by 90 degree. Therefore, ext is equal to em cos omega t minus beta x plus theta, and s bar xt is equal to em by eta cos of omega t minus beta x plus theta. The sum of the fields is given by ext is equal to em1 cos omega t minus beta x ay plus em2 cos omega t minus beta x plus theta az. Similarly, h bar field is given by em1 by eta cos omega t minus beta x EZ bar minus EM2 by eta cos omega t minus beta x plus theta along y direction. At x is equal to 0, we will get E bar is equal to EM1 cos omega t AY plus EM2 cos omega t plus theta AZ bar. And S bar is equal to EM1 by eta cos omega t AZ bar minus EM2 by eta cos omega t plus theta AY bar. So case 1, EM1 is equal to EM2 and theta is equal to 0. From equation number 1, we will get E bar is equal to M1 cos omega t AY bar plus M2 cos omega t AZ bar is equal to EM1 cos omega t into bracket AY bar plus AZ bar is called linear polarization. Case 2, if M1 is not equal to M, M1 is equal to M2 is equal to M and theta 2 is equal to minus 90 degree, then E bar is given by M cos omega t AY bar plus M cos omega t minus 90 degree AZ bar. So you will get ET is equal to EM cos omega t AY bar plus sin omega t AZ bar. Here theta is equal to tan inverse of sin omega t cos omega t. This is equal to omega t and this is circularly polarized wave. Case 3, when EM1 is not equal to EM2 and theta is equal to minus 90 degree, then E bar is given by EM1 cos omega t AY bar plus EM2 cos omega t minus 90 degree is equal to EM1 into cos omega t AY bar plus EM2 by M1 sin omega t AZ bar. Let EY is equal to M1 cos omega t, therefore EY by M1 is equal to cos omega t and EZ by M2 is equal to sin omega t, therefore squaring and adding will get EM EY by M1 whole square plus EZ by M2 whole square is equal to 1. This becomes elliptical polarization. So the waveform from linear, circular and elliptical polarization starts on. So next, power flow and pointing vector. The rate of energy flow at any point is given by the vector field product of E bar and S bar. It is denoted by P bar and P bar is called as pointing vector. P bar is equal to E bar cross S bar. The direction of energy flow is perpendicular to both E bar and S bar. Thus it is in the direction of vector E bar and S bar. S bar, curl of S bar. Consider UPW traveling in the direction. P bar is equal to BZ AZ bar. Let this wave is having E bar in X direction and S bar in Y direction. Therefore, E bar is equal to EX AX bar and S bar is equal to HY AY bar. Therefore, PZ AZ bar is equal to EX X bar cross HY AY bar is equal to EX SY AZ bar AZ bar cancel out. For perfect dielectric, E bar and S bar are given by EX is equal to EM cos omega t minus beta X and SY is equal to EM by eta cos omega t minus beta x. Therefore, PZ is given by EM square by eta cos square omega t minus beta z. Therefore, P bar is equal to EM square by eta cos square omega t minus BZ. This is power density. Average power is given by P average is equal to 1 by T naught 0 T EM square eta cos square omega t minus beta z dt. So, if you integrate and substitute the value of that omega t is equal to 2 pi, we will get P over is equal to M square by 2 neta.